Hello everyone, Akash here. The secret is to a great relationship, not so much about what should you do, but more about what you should not say. If you want your loved ones to feel loved, then it's very important what you do and what you say. Because wrong word can do more harm, you know that. I will go through 8 words in this video that you should not say to your loved ones. Number one would be, you make me mad. Every time you say this word to your loved ones, most likely he or she will get mad. Let's think about it. No one can make you mad. You can decide yourself you wanted to get mad or not. That is your choice, not theirs. Like, every time you do this, I feel like you don't respect me. Basically, if you say it in calm voice, most likely the other person will listen to you. Number two would be, I hate it when you do this. May not like everything about your relationship, but if you say you hate it, that will definitely going to have a negative effect in your relationship. Also think about the other person, how they will feel every time you say that. Many other ways you could say it without using the word hate. Maybe say, do me a favor, try to explain it better, and always be respectful. Number three would be, what is wrong with you? When you say that word, you might think it's not a big deal to say it, but for them it sounds like they are damaged goods, so they will take it like insulting. You could just say, what's wrong, are you okay, or everything okay. This will definitely going to have positive effect. Soft and caring tone is very important. Number four would be, that was stupid. Every time you use the word stupid, most likely your loved ones will completely ignore you. Your loved ones will not hear the word stupid. Your loved ones not going to separate the act from the insult. It will always be best for you not to use insulting word. Every time your loved ones feel insulted by you, most likely they will insult you back. If you want to maintain a healthy relationship, you must avoid all those insulting words. You don't want war in your life. You want peace in your life. Number five would be, you always do that. When you say that, you always forget this or that, or you always forget to feed the dog. Every time you say that, your loved ones will feel attacked. It's okay, sometimes they forget something that you want to remind them, but using the word you always do that is not helpful. I'm sure we all forget things sometime. Maybe your loved ones feel the same way about you, that you always forget things, but your loved ones never use that word on you. It's always important to remember, in a relationship there is no winner. Number six would be, just shut up. This is probably one of the worst words you could use. If you don't feel like to talk, you could just say, let's talk about this later. That's perfectly fine to say, completely shutting them down, saying shut up. That will definitely going to make things worse. When things get really heat up, you could just say, I need some time to think through. It will have better outcome, because most likely you both will be in better state of mind later on. Number seven would be, here we go again. When your loved ones wants to talk to you about something serious, anything maybe it has been talked about before, still don't say here we go again, because your loved one will feel disconnect and they need to communicate. So just have patience. Even you heard it before, maybe there is something new to it. The most important thing that your loved ones will feel, it does matter to you and you do care. Number eight would be, you drive me crazy. You want to say that as a compliment, that would be perfectly fine. But don't say, you drive me crazy when you do that or do this. In that case, most likely your loved ones will leave you alone. And that will definitely going to have negative effect on your relationship. Because good communication is the key of a successful relationship. Best thing would be, sit down with your loved ones and go through the list that you both agree on. Leave the things that you both disagree for later. Like I said before, there is no winner and there is no loser, so don't try to score points. So compromise, respect for each other, that will definitely lead you to a healthy relationship. Hope this video was helpful to you. Many great videos you'll find in my channel. Check it out and consider subscribe to my channel. Take care.